Yeah, I was just minding my own business, man, driving down the street. I looked to the right. Dude got his gun out, start shooting at my car. You know, shit, I was just thinking, why me? Why they do that to me, you know? And shit, cops are supposed to protect us and shit, but after that, I ain't never looked at them the same. Shit, man, we in SF, Tenderloin District, man. Eddie Leavenworth, you know we out here. All the little OGs and shit out here right now. Where I met most of my childhood friends, you know, we was all playing sports and shit. Still hang out with them today. Have little events, little barbecues and shit, you know, when I was younger. Listen to all different type of music. You can either let it make you or break you. My grandparents used to fuck around and shit in front of me, you know, so I was aware of things at an early age. Losing family members, losing the homies out here. Shit is crazy.
Made it through? You made it through, brother?
Yeah, I made it through.
God bless you.
Easier said than done, we know that.
Because my parents used to open, I said I was never. And I was out here damn near 50 years old. I got 12 years clean and sober now. They couldn't melt and pole crack on me today. It's hard. If everybody's in your family doing it, you think it's the norm. You think you're supposed to. Yeah, that's what's happening. That's what you see. I'm born and raised here. I'm a native. It was hard, and it's still hard. I'm 62 years old, and I'm still struggling. But I'm clean and sober.
That's all that matters.
And I will be the rest of my life.
Congratulations.
I do know that.
On this street right here, my car got aired out over here. Thank God I wasn't hit. Yeah, I was just minding my own business, man, driving down the street. I looked to the right, dude got his gun out, started shooting at my car. Shot out three of my windows. I had to drive opposite side of the traffic to get away.
So,
had no idea who it was, really.
To that moment, because I know when a shit like that happened, it'd be a split second. So, like, what was going through your head before it didn't immediately click in your head, I got to get out of that fight or flight reaction?
Are they aiming for me? That's what I was thinking. I was wondering. If, cause you know, there's bullets, gunshots around this motherfucker all the time, so you never really know where's it coming from until I heard the window, until I heard my windows breaking and shit. That's when I realized that it was for me and I had to get up out of there. Trying to make it home, you know, that was, my adrenaline just took over, you know, I smashed up out of there as fast as I could. My mind was just going 100 miles per hour.
Did it make you value your life more, like?
Yeah.
What's your take on that situation?
Yeah, for sure it made me value my life more, man. You know, being more aware of my surroundings, even when I'm driving. Now I'm always looking around, making sure, you feel me, no shit like that ever happens again. You gotta stay on your toes out here, man. You know, your first time getting slipping, get caught slipping, that could definitely be your last. Bitch ass.
What's your relationship with the police over here? I know they got a police station right over there.
Man, you know, same as everybody else's relationship with them, man. You know, they hate us. Harass us, they fuck with us all the time, even when we ain't doing nothing. We just try to stay clear, get out their way, stay out their way. Shit, when I was 14, I got arrested for some tagging, little tagging shit. Cop beat the fuck out of me on Thanksgiving. My head was all fucked up and shit, so they let me go. I was tagging in Chinatown, I used to tag and shit, so I had some little spray paint, I was tagging on the wall. Somebody had called the cops on me, so the cops pulled up on me right when I seen him. I threw my backpack and started running. Once the dude caught up to me, he was hella fast. He caught up to me, he grabbed me, he threw me head first into the gate, beat the fuck out of me. Brought me back to the station, you know, I was 14, so moms had to come get me. Once moms came and got me, she seen I was all fucked up and shit, so they dropped all the charges and everything, just let me go. You know, shit, I was just thinking, why me? Why they do that to me, you know? And shit, cops are supposed to protect us and shit, but after that, I ain't never looked at them the same. I see a lot of shit happening to everybody or whatever, but when it happens to you, it hits different, you know?
How do you think that affected your outlook on just police in general?
Shit, I don't trust them. I don't trust them at all. Yeah. All the shit going on everywhere, it just keeps getting worse and worse. I feel like it's been happening, but now that everyone got phones and cameras and shit, everyone's more aware of it, but they're not doing anything to change it. I think there's, of course, there's some good cops here and there, but for the majority, I don't think so. And I feel like cops are already, they already instilling cops that to profile.
I love my worry. You don't like me?
What's up with you? What's up with you?
Give me some love.
It's all good. It's all good. It's all
let me
good.
Give, no, don't back up, but let me give my.
It's all good.
Hey, yeah. Watch out, Dingley.
Come on.
Hey, come here now. What you doing?
I'm doing something.
Come
I gotta
here,
go.
Let me see. Happy every day. How y'all doing? I like your folk nails, though. Look at the nails.
You know, we love the people. We love the people.
No, just look at me, though. Just look over there. Don't look at me.
I know. Okay.
Don't look at me.
I'm going somewhere. I'll tell you.
I know where you're going, Father God. Whatever you're doing, keep it smile.
Yeah.
I love you too, Wody.
Hey,
give me some love. Hey,
you have a good
hope
day.
Hope y'all saw that part.
Love you too, Auntie. Yep.
And even with that, like growing up out here, it's a lot of course, users and addicts and homelessness and stuff. And like you see, it's all love, so this is like a real community and shit.
Yeah, it's definitely a real community. You know, it's not too big, so everybody's pretty tight. Everybody knew each other growing up. Everybody's families grew up together and stuff. So definitely a tight-knit community, even though the situations that's going on out here. People, their drug use progresses and they can't afford their habit anymore. They got to resort to doing crazy shit like selling drugs, stealing, you know, doing whatever they can to get that next high. Yeah, same thing with my grandpa. He passed away from using shit. He ended up catching Alzheimer's. It was fucked up because I seen him one day out here. He didn't even remember me. That fucked me up for sure. Shit killed me, man, you know? That's somebody I looked up to my whole life. And I seen what drugs did to him, you know? So I made a vow to myself that I would never do drugs like that. Oh, man, you gotta be relentless to make it out of here. To survive in here, man, you gotta be prepared for anything. The living situation over here is not good, you know? So you just gotta try to make it happen. Any way you can.
How big is the Tenderloin?
How big is it?
Yeah.
It's about a mile. It's about a mile long, a mile wide. It's in the heart of the city, you know? Right next to downtown. I know you guys heard about all the bipping going on. A lot of people get their cars bipped out here. A lot of people get their cameras taken and shit like that. But downtown's not too far from here.
So. You got the nice party a few blocks over. It's a whole different world.
A whole different world. Right there, they got a little area where they set up, where they let all the users go in there, and they give them clean needles, give them clean pipes, and let them do what they do in there, like the wire. That's what they're doing in there.
You see like that? Cause some people don't understand it. Don't come over there with that.
Yeah. See, I told you they tripping. It's the government type shit. That's why they tripping. That's another little after-school program right there. We used to go to Salvation Army, you know. They just really opened that up a couple years ago. It's an affordable gym. They got a swimming pool in there. Nice little outlet for the kids to go to. It's very diverse. There's a lot of Vietnamese. There's a lot of Cambodians, Laos and Thai, Latins out here, blacks, of course, whites. We got everything out here. That it's been forgotten about, so I feel like they don't give us enough attention to really dissect our problems and help us. They don't really do anything to help us out here. There's not too many outreaches out here. There's not too many jobs out here, you know. It's hard to live out here. So people resort to, you know, crime. When I would go to school and talk to a couple of my friends, you know, and then going to their houses and going to their neighborhoods and stuff, and it was totally different than mine. That's when I first realized, like, my living situation is kind of fucked up. This is all I knew for most of my life. It was tough. My parents had me when they were young. My mom had me when she was 14, and my dad was like 16. And yeah, man, there was this one time we had about like $5 to feed us all. You know, my mom made something happen, but gave me a chip on my shoulder, made me want to do better, you know, try my best to see where their mistakes were and try to capitalize off of that and basically just strive for more. You know, I knew that there's more out there for me. I didn't just want this. I didn't want this to be all I ever knew, you know. I didn't really have nobody to look up to besides my dad. And I kind of just had to make my own way.
I see you, bud.
We should probably walk back down that way. That's about it for the neighborhood. Or like the little spot that we do.
Dubai.
I fuck with Dubai, get fly, man. They got everything.
Give her some bands, she don't go and spend it on her body. That's what the spikes on. I'm the hottest nigga in
the city. They got the shoes, damn shoes.
My hoes like a shirt with no mics on.
See down here a little fit.
You know,
we
got it for the hygiene, man. Clean your asses.
Can get it at a better price.